Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. In my last video I showed you how you can use voice meter and a digital audio cable to get separate audio tracks for the audio of the game, voice over IP and your microphone, which is very useful when you record your gameplay and want to edit these audio sources individually. Some of you were concerned that using a digital audio mixer like voice meter would increase the audio delay of the games you play, which is a very valid concern that I had too, until I did a test where I found out that neither voice meter nor Dolby Atmos cause a noticeable delay increase. In the description down below you can find a link to that test video where I show you how I measured the audio delay and what the results were. Another very interesting question was what you should do when you like to listen to music while you are gaming or streaming, but don't want to record nor stream that music. This is an issue that my previous tutorial can't fix, as most applications like Spotify do not allow you to choose an output audio device. It just uses the default, which means that the music ends up in the same track as the audio of the game, as you can see here. Now, there are tools which hook right into Spotify and try to allow you to change the output device. And then there are applications like Audio Router, which allow you to change the output device on a per application basis. Sadly, I had very mixed results with all these tools, which is why I did not feel comfortable recommending these to you guys in the last video. But as it turns out, the Windows 10 Redstone 4 or Creator Spring update, which is planned to be released in April, will provide that functionality right out of the box. So I updated my test PC to one of the recent preview builds to show you how that works. When you right-click on the speaker icon, then you get a new option called Open Sound Settings. In here, you can then set the default playback device, which is the voice meter input as you will remember from the last video, and you can set the default recording device, which is my microphone in this example. A bit further down is the really interesting new config setting called App Volume and Device Preferences. In here, you can see all apps that play or record audio at the moment. What you can do here now is change the default output and input devices for each of these applications. So when I change the output device of Spotify from default to the auxiliary input of voice meter, then OBS does not receive the music from Spotify anymore, while I can still hear the music in my headset as the auxiliary input of voice meter uses A1 as output device. I can also enable A2 for this input so that I hear the music on my surround sound system, which is connected to the digital out of my sound card. And if you have a second sound card, which maybe connects speakers that are located in a different room, then you could add that as output A3 and have just the music play there. So with this new feature that allows you to change the default input and output devices of apps that otherwise do not allow you to do that, you can get very creative with how and where you play the audio of these applications. Now, what if you want to record or stream the music, but also want to keep it separate from the other audio sources? If you go to OBS, Settings, Audio and then Add Voice Meter's Auxiliary Output here, then you still won't get music in OBS. If you want to use that in OBS, then you need to select it as Desktop Audio 2 device, which is currently labeled Mic in my example, but this is now the audio from Spotify. So what if you already have some other device use Desktop Audio 2 inside of OBS? Well, in this case, you should get the additional digital audio cables from vb-audio.com, which are available as donationware. Now, to keep things organized, I rename hardware input 1 to VOIP and the second one to Music. Then I select cable A as input device, go to the audio settings, and change the default playback device of Spotify to cable A. You can do the same for other music apps so that they all use cable A as output device. Now Spotify sends its audio to hardware input 2 inside of voice meter, and I can still hear the music in my headset as A1 is selected as output device. Inside of OBS, I then select cable A as auxiliary audio device 2, and now I get the audio of Spotify inside of OBS. Now let's clean up the configuration inside of OBS a little. This time I will not use the desktop audio 2 device, as I might need that for the auxiliary output of voice meter in the future. So I put VoIP on the first, my microphone on the second, and Spotify on the third auxiliary input. Then I rename the audio tracks inside the output configuration and inside the mixer. Inside the advanced audio properties, I then need to decide what I want to do with these audio sources. When you are streaming, then you can only select one audio track that will be used for the stream. So when you use the first audio track for streaming and want to stream all your audio sources, then you need to enable track 1 for all of them. But I also want to record my gameplay and I want to be able to manipulate these audio sources individually. So I set game audio to use track 2, VOIP to use track 3, my microphone to use track 4, and the music goes on track 5. Inside the recording settings, I then need to select which tracks I want OBS to put into the recorded video file. Here I then select tracks 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. As one of you pointed out in the comments of my last video, it's very useful to record one audio track that contains all audio devices, since VLC and other media players will not allow you to enable all audio tracks when you watch a recorded video. So by having this track 1 which contains all audio devices, it gets much easier to review your footage outside of your video editing application, while you can still manipulate all tracks individually as you also record tracks 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, in my last video I told you that you need to change the output audio device inside your VoiceOver IP software so that we can put it on a separate audio track. With this new option in Windows 10, you don't have to touch the audio configuration inside the application. You can just come in here and change the input and output devices that Windows will then expose to the application as the defaults. So I'm really just scratching the surface here with this tutorial. You can go absolutely crazy with this new feature. You could, in example, have Firefox, Chrome, and the Edge browser use cable B and feed that into VoiceMeter. I don't know why you would need that specifically, but this is just one more example to show you what you can do with this new feature, virtual audio cables, and VoiceMeter Banana. What I don't like about this new feature in Windows 10 is that the application list does not get updated automatically when one starts to play or record audio. Currently, you need to leave and then re-enter app volume and device preferences to see that new application. It would also be great to see all applications that I changed the default input or output devices for, even when these are not active at the moment. But even with these quality of life issues, it is still an awesome new feature that will make many users very happy. Let me know in the comments down below what you think about this new feature and what you want to use it for. If you enjoyed this little tutorial, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as it's the awesome support that I get from my patrons which keeps Battle Nonsense alive. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time, maybe for my updated netcode analysis of Escape from Tarkov. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.